Hi, I'm Philip, and I'm going now to show you a set of very nice features for autonomously operating noise monitors. We will be talking about connecting a hard disk for memory extension, a measurement timetable, and a way to put your noise monitor to sleep. Here is the challenge. Depending on the setup in unattended noise monitoring applications, a lot of data might have to be stored and handled, particularly when you want to record the uncompressed audio parallel to the logging of the sound level data. I have prepared a list of typical use cases and added the memory consumption for each data logging case, assuming that you want to have a set of measurement data every 100 milliseconds.
This table shows if we record sound levels with typically 10 levels, it will occupy about 1.2 kilobytes per second. In case we are adding spectral information, in this case with 1/3 octave resolution, the data usage will be another 12 kilobytes per second, representing about 10 times more than wideband levels only. In case we add compressed audio, then another 12 kilobytes per second is required for the compressed audio file, about the same as for the spectral information. In case we decide to record uncompressed audio with 24 bits and 48 kilohertz, 144 kilobytes per second is required, representing about 12 times more than compressed audio. This is just the overview. Now I have prepared a few use cases, two for live and three for environmental noise. Okay, the two live cases are basic live sound monitoring here, where we only require the wideband levels for documentation purposes. And then the second live case, in case we have the same wideband level recorded, plus we want to also store compressed audio, allowing us to listen to special areas of interest later, if required. The environmental use cases, they always require the wideband levels, plus then, in very most cases, spectral information, and then we have with no audio, and with compressed audio, and one case with uncompressed audio. If we now look at the memory usage, the standard SD card of XL2 that has 8 gigabytes, so we can record here 81 days for live sound wideband values only, 7.5 days if we record also the compressed audio, or for environmental noise analysis, widebands plus spectral information, 7.5 days, and then with compressed audio, 4 days, and with uncompressed audio, where the usage is higher, 0.6 days can be used. The XL2 SD card can be replaced against the 32 gigabyte card, that is then prolonging the factors here by a factor of 4 to almost a year here, almost a month here, the same almost a month, half a month here, and 2.5 days in case we record uncompressed audio.
For unattended noise monitoring with uncompressed audio recording in parallel, even the larger XL2 memory fills up in a couple of days, meaning that you have to take measures to access the memory either via FTP or by replacing the memory card every few days. In order to overcome this bottleneck, we are now allowing to connect a hard disk drive to the NetBox that extends the available storage memory. Here is how it works.
This is a typical noise monitor for unattended measurements. It contains the XL2, the outdoor measurement microphone, NetBox for mobile data access, batteries and accessories. This case also contains the digital I/O board we are going to use later in this presentation. Take now any commercially available USB hard disk or memory stick and make sure it is formatted with FAT32. With the serial number of your NetBox, you may access it in the gateway mode. There you see its web interface, allowing you to control the system. As soon as you connect a properly formatted USB hard disk to the NetBox, it will be identified and recognized by the system. Now we see here it is accepted as a properly formatted archive, and it's calculating the amount of space it has available. And as soon as they are projected, they will be transferred from the XL2 memory into the hard disk memory. This data transfer may run completely in parallel to the measurement task, so it is handled in the background. Let's now see how the system looks if we connect with an FTP client. We connect and we see here the NetBox, and the NetBox has connected a USB drive, a weather station, and an XL2. And on the XL2, we find its projects. So we have two projects in here. And as expected, the XL2 on the USB drive in here, which is the image of it, we find XL2 data. We find its serial number in case we connect different XL2s. We find the year, we find the months, and then we find the project that needs to be synchronized, and we find the same folder as this one here. And as soon as a project is completed, it will be moved over to the USB drive. This action frees memory on the XL2 that can be now used for new measurement projects. This hard disk extension increases the XL2 storage system space to the size of the hard disk. So we can now have a look at our table again. We can now extend our table with the hard disk, with the archive hard disk, in my example used typically 2 terabytes here. So this extends then the sound level meter to record for 56 years, and with compressed audio 5.2 years. The same for environmental noise with spectral information more than 5 years. Half of it if we record also the compressed audio, and even with 24-bit 48 kilohertz uncompressed audio plus level recording, still more than 5 months recording available on that disk before it has to be transferred. In order to periodically terminate and store your projects, we have implemented a timetable function. You see its parameters up here. We go to the settings, and here we can define every day a start of the measurement and stop and save test. As said, with the save test, the project then is automatically transferred from the XL2 memory into the hard disk's memory. Then we have a sleep configuration here that will be discussed or explained in a second. Assuming that you only have to measure a few hours per day, then it would be great if the system couldn't be put to sleep for the rest of the time. For this purpose, we have implemented a sleep mode that is able to put the entire noise monitor to sleep. I show you the details here. If we put this tick on, then as soon as the project is completed, the system tries to go to sleep. With this flag set, the XL2 sends a command via the digital I/O to the connected I/O board. This command opens a switch that disconnects the power supply to the NetBox and puts this device to sleep. After this, the XL2 itself also goes into the idle mode, where only the real-time clock remains active and consumes only a few microamps. After the wake-up time arrives, the XL2 switches itself on and activates the digital I/O, sending a command to activate and close the switch again, and that supplies the NetBox and reboots the NetBox. This sleep mode significantly extends the lifetime of a single battery charge. But please bear in mind that as the NetBox is switched off, it cannot be reached via the website, and also FTP services are not functioning. So you have to wait until the NetBox or the noise monitor is waking up, until you can change its parameters and, for example, switch off the sleep mode.
This ends the presentation of the Archive hard disk feature. In order to use this feature, you have to have a memory device that is FAT32 formatted. The NetBox has to have firmware revision 2.30 or newer, and the XL2 needs to have hardware revision E0 or newer to be put to sleep. Thank you and bye-bye.